After receiving a reel of fiber, it's definitely a good idea to test it before committing additional resources placing it. Testing will also confirm fiber type and specification. Be sure to save those traces. We're going to be using an OTDR so that you can use them in case difficulties arise after placement. So there are two ways to test the fiber. You can use a bare fiber adapter or you can use a cam splice. I'm going to demonstrate on the reel testing using a cam splice. So strip your cable or remove the sheaths from your cable following manufacturer recommended practices. Now, some tools that you will need, of course, you need a cam splice base, the cam splice itself, and then you do need a pigtail. Pigtail is just basically a length of fiber with a connector on one end and nothing on the other. You also need a test fiber box. If you're testing a multi-mode reel, then you need to get an appropriate one. This is for a single mode system, and of course, an OTDR. Safety glasses, as always, before you start. So I'm going to show you how to terminate or place the yellow fiber on this cable into this cam splice. You need the fiber in one hand and you need a miller stripping tool on the other. Before stripping the fiber, place the cam splice inside the tool, lift the levers, make sure they're on a vertical, and then follow the symbol and make sure that the Corning letters are on top. And also make sure that the little caps are twisted off before you place the cam splice into the tool, just like that, and it will stop automatically. Strip, clean, and cleave your fiber, just like that, and we're gonna load it into the cleaver. 14 millimeter is what is required, so I'm gonna cleave the fiber, just like that, and then load it on this side of the tool, of the cam splice. Until it stops. I'm going to repeat on the pigtail. Load the second fiber. Make sure both of them have a small bend indicating that they're fully engaged inside before camming the cam splice. At this point, I have one of the fibers from my fiber reel connectorized. I need to connect this fiber now to the OTDR, and I will be using an SD adapter because I have SD connectors here. Clean the connectors as always before plugging them in. Now the fiber is continuous through the reel, and the only thing that's left is for me to connect the test fiber box to the OTDR port. Now we're ready to shoot a trace. Now that our OTDR is plugged in, we need to make sure we're in the right wavelength. I'm going to be using 1550 nanometers because that wavelength is more sensitive and reveals more. Now, if you were shooting a multimode system, again, you need to use the higher wavelength, which is 1300 nanometers. So I'm going to start my trace. After the OTDR has completed shooting the trace, I can see everything looks fine. There's my fiber test box. The length is about 300 meters. And then the length of my fiber is about 600 and or so meters. So I have everything that I paid for. Before shooting my OTDR trace, I went to either end of my cable, obtained the sheath marking number, and then subtracted those two numbers together to get the length on the reel, and I was able to confirm that with the OTDR. Now to test my next fiber, all I would have to do is lift up on the cam levers, remove this fiber, and prepare the next one in the manner that was demonstrated earlier. And that's it. If you have any questions, please give us a call or send us an email at cablesystems@corning.com. And remember, Corning Cable Systems recommends getting trained in fiber optic installation. We offer a series of classes, of course, and we thank you.